Allah pardon us by the Qur'an and make it our guide, light and mercy. Allah let us memorize what we've forgotten of it and educate us what we the ability to recite it day and night and make it an argument for us.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to your show In the Light of the Quran. Today we have a new light that we will delve into and try to benefit from and try to live our lives in this light, benefiting from the wisdoms that Allah has given us in these wonderful verses. We will take this number of verses from a surah called Fussilat. Now, this name actually basically refers to the verses of the Qur'an that they have been made very clear in detail. This is the meaning of the name or the title of this surah. Now, these verses that we will deal with today, this light that we will try to get, deals basically, or talks about the end of this worldly life. That's the most critical moment for every human being, which is the time when death comes to that person. People actually will be terrified, in great horror, because of the difficulty of that moment. It's a very critical moment, but the believers will have help from Allah. This is what we will find here. Then we will have a beautiful wisdom in dealing with people, treating people who have some kind of enmity or show some kind of hostility towards us. Let's recite the verses, then inshallah try to take the wisdoms out of them.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِّمَّنْ دَعَا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back. So these beautiful verses from Surah Fussilat are so wonderful. First of all, they give us the glad tidings about the end of this world. We know that everyone departs this worldly life with death. And death is a very critical time, very difficult for every human being. Now, because at the time of death, the soul realizes the truth of this life. And the belief comes to the heart. You know, throughout the life, certain people used to reject faith. But they know inside their hearts, in the depths, in the recesses of their hearts, they know that the truth about this life, that there will be a next life, and they should believe, or they should believe in the unity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at the time of death, all the covers that cover the truth that is in the heart will go away, and the truth will be manifest. So the person, the soul, realizes that this is the end of this life, and there will be a next life. It will be resurrected for the reckoning on the next life. So this is why the soul suffers from great fear. It will be frightened. It will be in a state of horror. So this is why the soul of the believer actually will refuse to leave the body. This is why it will cling to the corners of the body. It will cling to the fingers, to the nerves, to the muscles, to the bones. It doesn't want to leave the soul because it knows once it leaves the soul, that's the end. And that there will be punishment for it in the hereafter. So because of the horrors at this time, and even some narrations say that shaitan will come to the person at that time, especially the believer, to try to make him slip into disbelief at that very critical moment. It's a very difficult moment because we are slipping from one life to another, from this, the life of this world, to the life of the grave. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the glad tidings to the believers that he's saying, those who say Allah is our Lord, he's the one that we worship in truth, then they remained steadfast, they followed the straight path. At the moment of death, that's the most critical moment, the angels will descend to them, will be sent down to them to assure them, to reassure them, to say to them, don't fear. Don't fear of what is lying ahead of you, and don't grieve over the shortcomings that you had in this worldly life. Don't fear and don't grieve. And they will give them the glad tidings. And we give you the glad tidings of the hereafter, or the glad tidings of paradise, that it is for you. Don't worry, just be reassured, be confident, be calm and be peaceful. Because paradise will be for you, because Allah has promised you paradise. At this critical moment, Allah gives this kind of solace, this kind of comfort to the believers at this very critical moment, which is the moment of death. And the soul actually would be looking for any source of comfort and reassurance. And Allah gives them that through the angels' beautiful faces. And it's known from the stories of some believers from the early generations that when death came to them, it is that they were saying that we could see faces that we recognize, faces of angels, beautiful faces that shine, that radiate with a lot of light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now this is a gift from Allah to the true believers. So we should, now the wisdom that we can take from this verse is that we should work hard, exert ourselves to please Allah so that at the moment of death, we will be reassured and we will see these wonderful angels, the handsome and beautiful faces of the angels, the radiant faces of the angels coming to give us glad tidings of paradise. And these angels will say to the believers, we are your helpers in the worldly life as we used to help you and guide you to the truth. We are your helpers in the hereafter, in the second life as well. So don't worry. And you will have everything your souls desire on the day of judgment. You will have everything you wish and everything you wanted from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of this will be a gift that you will get from your Creator who is forgiving, who is merciful because of what you used to do. Then Allah says, and this wisdom is very important for us, Allah says, who is better in speech than someone who calls to Allah? Who's better than that? Someone who dedicated his life or her life to call to the way of Allah, to call the people to the truth, to call the people to the way that leads to paradise. Who is better than that person in speech? Who is better than him? And you know, the sequence of verses shows us that the ones who will receive this kind of welcome, this kind of reassurance at the moment or at the time of death, the first ones to receive that will be the ones who call to the way of Allah. Who's better in speech than someone who calls to the way of Allah and does righteousness, does more acts of piety that please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then he says, I am from those who submit themselves to Allah. Submission to the word of Allah. Submission to the teachings of the Qur'an and the Sunnah. Now if we fulfill these things, we call to the way of Allah and we do righteousness and we submit ourselves to the teachings of Allah, now we will be reassured at the moments, at the times of death, with paradise, with the glory that Allah and the dignity that Allah prepared for the righteous ones. Then Allah says, states a very important fact, which is very important light for us and wisdom. Allah says, goodness and evil are never equal. Goodness and evil will never be equal. The good things are high in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whereas evil is very low and decadent and is abhorrent to our Creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah says, repel the evil that comes to you, repel it with that which is best. Now if people treat you very harshly, they deal with you in a very unjust way, what you do, treat them in the way that is best, in the best manner, with the best character of Islam and of the Muslims. So Allah says, if you do that, if you repel evil with good, if you repel evil with that which is best, the one between him and you there is enmity, he will turn into a closest friend, a very warm friend. Imagine that. Now this is one of the principles of dealing with people, especially in da'wah, especially when we call the people to Islam. There will be people showing us enmity, severe enmity and hostility. Now what we do to those, repel their evil with what is good, with good treatment, with good behavior, with kind and gentle answers and gentle behavior. Now this will turn them into very close friends, very warm friends who will actually be helpers to us. Then Allah says this is not for everyone. Not everyone will get that. The only ones who will get that are the ones who are truly patient, the ones who persevere in patience, the ones who exert themselves in patience, and they bear so much hardship and so much hostility from others. They remain patient. Allah will grant them this, that even their enemies will become close friends to them. So only the patient ones will receive that, and only someone with a great fortune from Allah, someone who's really fortunate by Allah, that refers to true belief and true knowledge from the Quran and the Sunnah. Now the wisdoms that we can take from that is the way of the Muslim is to call to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with patience and perseverance, and this will make the enemy a friend. The enemy will turn into a friend. This is from the blessings of Allah in this life. But as to the moment of death, which is the most critical moment, the most difficult time for every human being, reassurance will come to the believer through the angels, radiant faces, beautiful faces, telling the believers, don't fear the future, don't fear what is ahead of you. You will be granted paradise. You will be given what you were promised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let's, now the wisdom or the lesson that we can take from this, the light that we can live with from these wonderful verses, from this wonderful light, is let's follow the straight path. Let's say our Lord is Allah. Let's follow the straight path so that the angels will descend to us at the moment of death, which is the most difficult. They will come to be our friends, to be our helpers, telling us, don't fear. Don't fear and don't worry about your shortcomings in this life. Unlike the disbelievers, the angels will come and will be kicking them and striking them on their faces and on their backs because of the evil they did. Now inshallah, we hope that we will be among the ones who receive the glad tidings at the moment of death. How we do that? Follow the straight way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until we meet with another wisdom, another light from the Qur'an, until we meet with another episode from In the Light of the Qur'an. I leave you in peace. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
By the Quran, Allah pardon us by the Quran and make it our guide, light and mercy. Allah, let us memorize what we've forgotten of it and educate us what we. To recite it day.